for me, and they took us in their car to one of our institutions in Bhubaneswar. And this is, in short, my experience on that day, on 24, 25, 26th, in Iskandamal district.
Father, how long have you been there in Orissa?
I came to Orissa in 1970, after my 10th class. I had my initial formation to be a priest there in Orissa. Then I was in different places like Ranchi, Pune Papal Seminary, and got ordained in 1980. So 28 years now I am working as a priest in Orissa.
What do you feel is the reason for all these unfortunate episodes that are happening in the last almost 15 years, particularly in Kandamal district?
I simply repeat what I have told some TV people earlier. This is not what I not hear, what I notice, my observation. See, the last time the trouble began in December, it was in a place called Bamuningam. It began with the shopkeepers. Once Hindu shopkeepers are there, Christian shopkeepers are there. This is some 15-20 years back, probably the entire district had not a single shop owned by a Harijan or an Adivasi, it may be Hindu or Christian. The economy of that district was controlled by the outsiders, high caste people who have settled there. They have bought the land from the Adivasi people, they have made good fortunes there, and it was a sort of barter system that is prevailing. You buy things from my shop, I give you this, you give your hill products like turmeric and all that. So I have, and that is one reason. The economy which was controlled by them, others one day, they are sharing it, the local people. Secondly, the literacy standard of the people. Because of the efforts of the missionaries and works of various NGOs, they are improving in their social and economic life. I don't think this, I believe these are the reasons, and mainly the beneficiaries of the church or the NGO programs goes to these deprived classes. I believe this is their main reason why they would not appreciate our presence there.
Any time and effort has been made to dialogue with these elements, Father?
In this district, in small level in our parishes, number of efforts have been made. And it's a wrong thing, the notion that it is not a problem between the Hindus and Christians. Absolutely no. I told I was taken care in a Hindu family. Even last time in December, when people fled away, it is they who protected many of them. So it is a group of people or organizations who are involved in it. It is not one place. Last time, the local people who joined with them, they even came and asked pardon. They said, if you don't join us, we are going to set fire for your house. So a good number of outsiders getting inside of this, a terror is created. They have a few local leaders who belongs to one or other organizations, maybe the Sangh Parivar people, and then this takes place. It's really wrong to say that the local people, and there is a tension between Hindus and Christians.
What do you think about the enforcement of the rule of law?
That I can just say, maybe I forgot as I was narrating my story. When I reached Nuagam, the place I know very well, I walked that place, more than one dozen policemen were standing there. With folded hands I asked them, sir, please help us. For asking them, I got one more hit from one among the attackers. Police did not turn, told this head. And for a moment, the simple sister slipped away from the crowd and went to the